Let's talk about the article that you wrote.
The logic article.
The logic article.
Yeah. So primarily what Cade and I do is, I guess what we consider to be culture, right? Culture, but with a basis in music, because that's kind of where, I mean, we're all, friends for, playing games, music, whatever it is, but I think you and I kind of connect on a different level for the music, you know what I mean? So with the culture stuff, we have different ways of looking at that. We could look at the same album and you look at it completely different than I do. But for this Logic album, me personally, and you can see it in the article, I thought it was really good. And there's not very many albums that I can listen to 6, 7, 8 times in a row. I mean, I listen to it at work and I can kind of just zone it out, but it was good. It was easy to listen to. It wasn't distracting. There wasn't very many songs where I was like, okay, yeah, I'm not listening to this right now. You know
Right.
what I mean? AJ, can you pull up the track list for that? Because I actually do want to get into
Yeah.
specific tracks.
And like I yeah, absolutely. After reading your article and you kind of sharing those details with me, it was actually a really, really good album. I enjoyed it. Front to back, it was very deep. You know what I mean? And a lot of people hate on this guy.
They do.
I don't understand it.
That's what I
You
said in
know
my
what I
article
mean?
too. I don't I think I almost said that verbatim. It's like I don't know. I think just kind of what I touched on is like he's not what everybody wants him to be. You know what I mean? Like he's so good, so talented with his lyrics. The beats are the beats. And to me, I don't think it's not like a beat-centric style of music, you know what I mean? But in terms of his lyrical ability, dude, it's so good. You know what I mean? I think it's probably one of the best. And people talk about lyricists, and they might say Kendrick or J. Cole, which are also fantastic, right? But my question is, why does nobody have Logic in the same avenue? You know what I mean? What makes them different as lyricists, and how deep they get with their lyrics as compared to Logic? Why? That's my main question with that.
Yeah, I mean, you're absolutely right. It's like he's just not, he's really different from every other rap in the game right now. That's why it doesn't fit
That mold.
that mold. Yeah, exactly. And it's just like I don't think he's that bad. I never thought he was that bad, and I just like don't understand it. It's like good.
It
I
was
mean,
really good.
yeah.
I
I
really
mean,
liked
and
it.
then all the people that are hating on him are like, probably can't.
Well,
And it's just like, I don't get it.
the other thing is I think there might be a little bit of a stigma with who his fans are. You know what I mean? I feel like no, I'm not saying like the Rat Pack or whatever, but like the stereotype of who like hardcore Logic. I feel like there's memes that have come out about like, Logic fans or this and that. You know what I mean? So there's like I think that's part of what, like, because nobody's like, with J. Cole, like, oh, J. Cole fans be like, you know what I mean? Like, there's nothing like that with J. Cole or Ken. You know what I mean? But there is something like that with Logic, which I don't know. I don't know why. But tracklist. In my article, I had, and we have it up here on another screen, Hit My Line, Soul Food 2, and Man I Is. I thought those were the best songs, in my opinion. I don't know if you probably don't remember the track list top to bottom, but
Like Soul Food too.
Soul Food 2.
That's probably one of my favorites.
Yeah, and I've never really been like a follower of Logic myself, so I didn't it took some digging to figure out that this was a sequel to Under Pressure, because this is called No Pressure, right? So in the one of the songs, he says the Under Pressure sequel. So I had to go back and look, and the first studio album that he had with No ID was Under Pressure. So it's kind of cool how he did it. He's got Under Pressure, right? He's coming out. He's like brand new, released his first studio album, had albums in between, and then finished it off, which we never hear of people retiring in rap, right? But finish it off with No Pressure. I think that's kind of cool.
That is
Under
cool.
Pressure to No Pressure.
Getting all that weight off his chest. And I think that, Under Pressure, it's the album cover is him graffitied on a wall, right? If I'm not mistaken.
Yes. Yeah, I believe so.
I'm I
Check.
no, is it not?
No?
Okay. Well,
Well, then you don't know shit.
I'm thinking this one. Oh, it's this one. Yeah.
I wish
we
could pull it up on the screen, but get that going later. Huh. Which one was the one with him graffitied on the wall?
But yeah, anyway, I mean, he came out when we were freshmen in college.
Yeah, that's actually when I discovered. I wasn't like underground Logic listener. It was like it was like one of those things where you just kind of came across his music, heard a song, and then you start looking through all the other shit.
Yeah, yeah. Am I right? Oh, all right.
That's
what I thought.
Is there two album covers? Is that what it is?
Yes, this one.
Yeah, okay. Well, he usually has a couple album covers.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, this is the first album I got introduced. And can't pull it up on the screen, but, you know, he's graffitied on a wall. And I remember it coming out in college. A buddy who's going to Arizona State was like, yeah, check this out. I listened to it and I was like, yeah, this is good. This isn't bad at all. I actually like this.
Was it freshman in college? What year was it released? Because I remember listening to 14. Logic before I was in college.
So 2014, so we were the freshmen, sophomores.
In college.
College, yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I mean, it was good. I think that's why I liked Under Pressure too, is because it was like, wow, there's transition. You're going from, you know, starting off your career, now you made it.
Yeah.
Right? Huge deal from Twitch, and it's like.
Yeah. Which is
you, dude.
Yeah. Which is something I didn't talk about at all in my thing. I don't know. I just couldn't really figure out a way to fit it in with what I was writing. It was like an album review.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it would have just been like a little tidbit.
He got a Twitch. That's kind of like, you know, the trickled stuff at the bottom.
Yeah,
that was good. Yeah, I thought the article was very well written.
Thank you, appreciate it. But yeah, with that Twitch stuff, I mean, what do you think about him signing it? I mean, I knew he was a gamer. I've actually watched his YouTube a while back, and he's a gamer, so it makes sense. It's not like he's like looking for another deal. But what do you think about him signing to a big streaming platform?
Dude, I mean, hey, man, if that's the move, that's the move. Like, go for it. Like, who are we to say, like, dude, no, don't do that, man. You're throwing away your rap career. Like, fuck what people say.
Right.
Like, do what you want. Mm-hmm. You know, I think that's cool. You know, get a ton of money, do what you love. Get it.
Yeah. That's the other thing, though, is that I don't think that's it for music for him.
Oh, yeah, there's no doubt.
If you're into music, you're gonna release. Yeah. You're gonna have an itch to release new shit.
Absolutely, and that's the cool thing, man. He has like, you know, the way where he went, both situations.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like, hey, I'm about to make a ton of money doing what I love.
Yeah.
I want to return to music. The future, like, I'm gonna do it.
Right.
That's cool, man. Yeah. That is like the goal.
That's
like,
freedom right there.
He's got it.
Yeah.
So, you know, shout out to Logic, man. Doing it, bro.
Yeah.